Hi, today I am going to install steering wheel remote controls for my stereo in my 1989 Avanti. So a couple weeks ago I bought a modern touchscreen stereo. It's from a company called Joyang, and I got it on eBay. It was about $250, something close to that. It's 6.2 inch touchscreen, and essentially it's an Android powered radio, and it operates kind of like just having an Android pad in your car. So far I'm pretty happy with it. The support from Joyang isn't very good, and the directions are all terrible, broken English, and the interface isn't that great, but the stereo has some amazing capabilities. The sound quality is great. The video, the screen is visible in bright light. This is a convertible, and I've driven it out in normal daylight, and you can completely see the screen. And then the main bonus, and they don't market this very well because I didn't know it when I bought it, is the system has Apple CarPlay, so I can plug my iPhone into it, and the device will basically act as an extension of my iPhone, and I can use voice commands for navigation and to send and receive texts. And I really like that because it brings this car into the 21st century and makes it feel modern. I'm going to talk a little bit more about the stereo later, but the emphasis of this video is adding the steering wheel controls. These are the controls I bought on eBay. It comes with these two individual remotes, and they attach to your steering wheel with simple 3M two-sided tape. And I think these will fit really nice on my steering wheel. That's pretty much how I plan on mounting them. What I like about this solution is it's fairly elegant. It looks normal. A lot of the steering wheel remotes that you can get really look bulky and terrible. So I just like the simplistic nature of these. This device right here is the receiver for the remotes, and these hook up to your stereo. As long as your stereo is able to handle the steering wheel remote. And what you want to do to make sure that it can is you would look at the wiring diagram, and there needs to be a key one and a key two wire. And I'll show you those later. So one of these is power, ground, and I forget which one is which, but one of these is key one, key two. These are the instructions that came with the remote. And so according to the instructions, the white line is key two and the gray line is key one. So on my stereo, which I just pulled out, let's see, this pink line is key two, and this brown line is key one. So I'm going to go ahead and twist those together and solder them, and that's going to be our first step. The next step is to hook up the power. On the wiring diagram, it has this red wire going to the AC power for accessories, and the black is the ground. I'm going to go ahead and hook those up. I have all the wires soldered together, and now I'm just going to tape them up with electrical tape. And I've got one more connection I need to make on my stereo, and then we're going to try setting this device up. I've made all my connections. Now I am going to organize and wire tie this big mess. This is what things look like now that I have the wire harness tied down and organized. Right now, this remote is just kind of flopping around. I want to put everything in the dash and test it before I actually figure out how and where to mount this. So what I'm going to do now is slide this inside and just get it in position for a test. I've got everything in position now. I put the remotes up on top of the dash. I don't want to attach them until I'm sure they're going to work. So let's turn everything on and see what happens. All right, got a little Elvis. I'm gonna stop this. And I'm gonna play with this with the radio setting. So that's too loud. Let's see if the volume goes down. Let's see if this does the volume without me even making any settings. All right, it does not. All right, it did not work without me going into some settings. So let's find the settings menu and see if we can make it work. These are the general settings for the Joyin unit. If I scroll down here, there's steering wheel settings. So I'm gonna play with those and see what I can get going. All right, so there's some instructions right there. It says, please hold the steering wheel into the learning state. So you've got some broken English there, but I think what it means is hold down this button and then press the corresponding button on there. So I'm gonna hold down the plus volume and the message changes, and I'm gonna hit the plus volume as the one. And now I'm gonna do minus. I'm gonna hold down minus. Whoops. I think I may have screwed that up. So minus, I'm gonna go back and do plus. And plus. All right, let's see if those work. So I went through the buttons one by one and matched them up to symbols on the radio in the steering wheel settings section. And anyway, I got everything working. So if I push the plus, volume goes up. If I push minus, volume goes down. This is the setting I was really most interested in, is being able to advance to the next channel. So anyway, that works. That was the thing I was most interested in, because when you're driving your car, you don't really want to be taking your hands off the road to be fussing with the radio. All right, so now I'm gonna go ahead and mount these on my steering wheel and see how they work. One of the settings I was most interested in was being able to advance to the next channel on your radio without having to look down and find the buttons. Finding buttons on a touch screen is a lot harder than a older style radio with big buttons. So I wanted to be able to set that. And I originally tried this symbol, but it turned out to be this symbol. So when I set the remote to do that symbol, then I was able to advance the radio. So that was the only one that was tricky, that wasn't intuitive.
Okay, I'm ready to mount. What I did is I did some tests with my fingers just to see, you know, how far my thumb reached naturally to hit these buttons. And for me, it works out to be about right there. But you should do some actual finger tests. Just hold the remote where you want and reach out to it with your thumb and see how it works. I've got the buttons in place now. So, so advances the radio, raises and lowers the volume. Mute works. The other remote is on this side. Let's see what happens when I push these. All right, looks like I still have to set up the GPS, but at least the button does something. All right, I went ahead and set that up. Let's see what happens now. Look at that. So I'd never actually used the GPS function of this stereo before. And anyway, that button brought it right up. Let's see. I don't remember what I set this one to do. This one I set up to do, to change like what the source audio was. So it's just kind of switching between things. So every time I push this, it just switches between. Different sources. So that's interesting. So this is this device takes SD cards, and I've got music on an SD card. So the source went to that after enough pushing. So that's the phone button. I push that and my phone comes up. This device has hands-free calling, so that's pretty cool. That's the hang-up button. Let's see if we can get back to the radio. So I'm going to push my source button a few times. There's the radio.
Be welded. Then we attempt to break it. If it breaks, it will not be a safe weld and your vehicle could come.
That's it for this video on setting up remote steering controls for your stereo. I got this off eBay. It didn't really have a name. It was, just one of those generic Chinese things, but it works real nice. There are a couple different ones available. Just make sure that your stereo has a key one, key two input for steering wheel controls, and make sure that the steering wheel control you buy has the key one, key two receiver with it. Some of the remotes you see on eBay are infrared. Those are real fussy, and you have to have a stereo that'll take that one. Okay, have a great day and good luck with your projects.